for.
What's wrong with France? That's the question being asked in Brussels and elsewhere in the run-up to the French presidential election. To answer it, Euronews has brought together Jacques Barrot, a vice president of the European Commission, and Paul Magnet, director of the Institute of European Studies at the University of Brussels. In his book, Europe is Not What You Think It Is, Jacques Barrot aims to dispel French-held Eurosceptic prejudices.
Ces doutes sur l'Europe
These doubts about Europe reflect France's own lack of self-confidence. The French have not really embraced Europe, which explains partly their no to the referendum on the Constitution. There's always the temptation to believe Europe is really a Trojan horse of accelerating globalization, whereas Europe can, on the contrary, help to alleviate these fears.
The
French closely identify themselves with Europe, much more so than others, perhaps not more than the Germans, but certainly more than the British or the Poles today. And there's often the feeling among French leaders and the French people that they see Europe as one of their things they cannot give up. They can't just become one of the 27 member states, not even just one of the 6 founder members. Europe must, in a way, remain French. After all, it's bound up with the French political rhetoric of De Gaulle and Mitterrand. But as soon as Europe stops resembling France, the French have a problem with Europe.
Elle n'est plus tout à fait à l'image de la France. Les Français ont un problème avec l'Europe.
Il faut venir, comme je l'ai fait à la Commission.
You have to join the Commission, like I did, to see this shift between a France that would prefer to have documents signed by France.
Soit signée française, alors qu'en réalité, il peut y avoir des avancées.
But in reality, any step forward is teamwork, and France would be better off to accept being one among others and to play the role of moderator.
Comme les autres, mais en même temps, un Européen conscient qu'elle a cette mission d'animation.
Souvent, les Français donnent aussi l'impression de ne pas.
Often, the French also give the impression of not managing to put over their way of seeing things. For example, with public services. It's known that public utilities have a special place at the heart of French political culture, unlike other European countries. But the French can't convince others, indeed seem frustrated by the fact that what they perceive as a very honourable heritage is not shared by all. That is perhaps due to a game which French leaders often play when delaying the opening up of the energy markets. In fact, they simply want to make sure French companies get a bigger market share. The trouble is, they end up undermining the image of the public utilities while failing to convince their partners that behind their defense of national interests are economic concerns and territorial cohesion.
Et si la France avait un peu plus.
And if France stood back a little bit and said, OK, we highly regard our public utilities, but that the service can be filled in different ways, I'm sure that the French idea would be sellable to our competitors and partners.
Et à nos partenaires. Mais le problème, c'est que nous sommes.
But the problem is that we're sometimes too rigid in our ideas, and we don't manage to understand how the objectives which we seek can be achieved by other means.
Nous recherchons peuvent être atteints par différentes méthodes.
Bien malin, celui qui sait ce qu'est l'Europe sociale à la française.
You have to be quite clever to understand the French concept of a social Europe today. Is it based on a stronger role for dialogue between the trade unions and the employers, which the French have never truly supported since the departure of Jacques Delors? Is it through stronger employment legislation, of which the French are fond, but which they have difficulty in selling to the British and Central European countries? Or is it more of a redistribution through economic tools, i.e. the budget and taxation? But there too, when it's a question of increasing the share of the budget, the French are very reticent. And when it's a question of harmonizing Europe's taxation, they're not very enthusiastic either. Thus, it seems there's a shift between the principle of a social Europe and the reluctance to discuss precise actions.
There's a contradiction between the idea the French have of a Europe built on their own social model and at the same time the will to extend the system to all. This is not possible. They would have to choose what would remain as part of French culture and history and what would be acceptable to the rest of Europe.
Restera
But I think today there is an area in which France could push Europe to act, for example, providing lifelong training for its citizens.
Dans lequel la France pourrait pousser l'Europe à agir, c'est d'exiger partout une formation tout au cours de la vie pour tous les citoyens.
La France donne parfois
France sometimes suffers from Gulliver syndrome. One hears it from the left and the right. There's a deep French reflex to desire to see a strong influence by the greater countries within the decision-making process of Europe. There's also a certain mistrust with respect to the Commission, where all the states put on the same footing, and even with respect to the Council, where the bigger countries have the impression that the complicated voting system gives smaller countries more weight than they should have.
Donne aux petits pays plus de poids qu'ils ne devraient en avoir.
J'ai le sentiment aujourd'hui quand même dans la campagne présidentielle.
I have the impression that in the presidential campaign, a certain number of remarks have been made calling for the scrapping of the unanimous vote on some issues, such as European justice, the police and immigration.
De l'Europe policière, de l'Europe de l'immigration. Là, il y a quand même.
There's a realization in France that one cannot always work unanimously. This is extremely important. Take, for example, the Airbus drama. If Airbus is really a community company, it should not have had to suffer from numerous national interferences.
Et on doit laisser cette industrie européenne vivre sa vie.
Je dirais que le meilleur service que le prochain président
I would say that the best service the next French president can do for Europe is undoubtedly to think of the role as of a unifying one between the French and the other EU members, i.e. to make sure that France does not see itself as the only one carrying the European torch, the principal inspirer of the European project, but rather like an actor among others. Yes, of course, having a certain historical stature, but which recognizes that it can make France more European and not just make Europe more French.
Évidemment, nous sommes d'autant plus attendus.
This is what is expected of us. The no in the referendum was a blow, almost like Zidane's headbutt.
Alors que nous étions peut-être
proches. We were within victory, but then what a foul.
Et il faut maintenant, vis-à-vis des Européens,
we now have to respect Europe to show the face of a constructive France which makes suggestions and does not cry over fears of globalization and a too liberal Europe.
Trop libérale, mais qui comprennent que
a France which understands a Europe based on a social market economy and recognizes that Europe can actually help men and women to adapt to the growing challenges of globalization.
Pour leur permettre de s'adapter à la mondialisation.